Hey, developers, do you ever get the sense that there are a ton of resources out there when you're trying to learn about Azure? Do you ever wonder if there might be ways that would fit your learning style better? And maybe there might be some tips and tricks for using these resources that can help you learn even faster. My name is April Edwards. So join me on a guided tour of the Azure Learning Resources available to you so you can get answers to all of these questions and so much more.
Now, let's visit virtual training days.
Hi, I'm Garrett Bundy. I am a global director, part of our Microsoft trainer team. I have a team of 16 trainers spread across the globe that all support our Microsoft Virtual Training Day events.
What are virtual training days?
So our virtual training days are these free, in-depth, instructor-led trainings that are found on the local Azure events page. And so when you attend one of our virtual training day events, what you get is this opportunity to see great content delivered by our Microsoft technical trainers. And our content ranges from fundamentals level content all the way up through advanced content.
How can a developer get started with virtual training days?
So if you want to get started with virtual training days as a developer, I highly recommend you take a look at the Learn path first. So go to Microsoft Learn, take a look at the content that's there, and then register for one of our virtual training day events in the context of what it is you're looking for. So whether you're a DevOps person and you're working with GitHub, or you're a database developer and you do open source, we have something for you.
How can developers get the most out of virtual training days?
So when I think about how developers can get the most out of a virtual training day experience, I think the interaction is key. We do staff each one of these events with these subject matter experts, so you have an opportunity to ask your questions in real time of these subject matter experts. So if you're attending an open source database migration course and you have a question about something with this specific version of the database you're using, you could probably get your question answered in there. But it all goes back to the content we use really is based on that Microsoft Learn content. So you have an opportunity not only just to interact with our instructors, but also integrate with the Microsoft Learning site as well.
What's one thing that most developers might not know about virtual training days?
So I think the one thing most developers don't know about our virtual training days is that they exist. A lot of people associated the virtual training days with just the fundamentals courses. And while we do have those fundamentals courses, we want developers to understand that there are a ton of courses out there available that focus specifically on your work and your role as a developer, whether it's in Azure, like I said, or around our security platform, or if you're a citizen developer in Power Platform, we have an event for you there as well.
Our next stop is at Microsoft Learn.
I'm Judy McNeil, Senior Program Manager on the Learn Content Team.
How do developers get started with Microsoft Learn?
Well, Learn has over 1,000 courses, and we cover a wide variety of topics, including Azure, AI, software development, lots of topics. You can start with one of the popular learning paths like Azure Fundamentals, or you could jump to the browse page and use search or filter to focus on the thing that's important to you. You can also explore Microsoft certification paths, where the Learn content is there to help you get ready for certification exams.
Why should developers go to Microsoft Learn?
Developers should go to Microsoft Learn because we have over 1,000 courses. We cover a wide variety of topics for developers, including Azure and AI, software development topics, software development tools. You can start with some of the popular learning paths or use our browse page to search for your specific topic. You can also explore the Microsoft certification paths for developers as well. We have content to help you get ready for the certification exams.
Are there any tips for developers using Microsoft Learn?
Developers will love the fact that our practice environments are, first of all, free, and secondly, you can experiment with the Microsoft products there. You can use them to explore Azure and how you would do development on Azure. The environments time out, so if you ever felt like, what would happen if I do this, go ahead and do that. You learn, experiment. Our environments clean up themselves.
What's one thing most developers don't know about Microsoft Learn?
Microsoft Learn is publishing developer-centric topics every day. Tell us what you're interested in. We'll recommend content that matches your goals.
Next, let's visit Tech Community.
Hi, I'm Anna Chu, and I am the community lead for Microsoft Tech Community.
When someone goes to Tech Community, what will they find?
When people first come to the tech community, they find a wealth of resources to help them keep up to date with the news and updates that help tech professionals meet the demands of new challenges that are facing them today, both at work and at home. And if when you first visit techcommunity.microsoft.com, members can discover and discuss technology solutions with Microsoft engineers, be able to acquire new skills, and become inspired by innovative product use cases, be able to give and receive technical guidance, and ultimately enjoy support and encouragement from other fellow technologists. The community provides members with a lot of how-to guidance and a platform for collaborating with other technologies and a place to find belonging, which is really important these days.
Why should developers go to Microsoft Tech Community?
Developers should go to the tech community because there are fellow developers there. Being able to, converse with your fellow community to understand how to build apps or to learn a little bit more about specific technologies, emerging ones, because our product teams, especially in the Azure space, are constantly innovating and sharing new information every day. So it's a really powerful learning tool and also a safe haven to know that there are other people who are, learning at the same quickfire, rapid pace that everyone else is experiencing. So definitely tech community is a place for developers.
How do developers get started with Microsoft Tech Community?
Just take a look and see what communities are related to what you're trying to create and manage. And this will allow you to curate your experience specifically for you. That dashboard that allows you to personalize your experience is certainly a great way for you to focus on the technologies that you care about. You can also dive headfirst into our blogs to check out what Microsoft Learn has to offer. We have got a really great Microsoft Learn community that is growing every single day. And we really focus on making sure that you have access to all the different resources to continue sharpening your skills through that community.
Is there anything that tech community developers might want to pay particular attention to?
We have a really great place for anyone who cares about developing on Azure. There is an Azure developer community, and there's a great blog that is authored by many of the people who at Microsoft are in charge of helping developers learn more about the resources that are available to them. And this blog was created specifically for sharing those tips and tricks and developer updates within Azure Sphere. So if that's something that you really care about, take a look.
What's one thing that developers might not know about Microsoft Tech Community?
If you're developing on Windows, we have an entire blog that's dedicated to Windows Dev App Consult, and it's full of useful information regarding your efforts. So that's one area that doesn't get a lot of attention, but we certainly are trying to grow it. But just take a look. There is a really powerful search capability within the tech community that allows you to explore all the different areas around developing on using Microsoft products. But sometimes they can be hidden because the way that the tech community is structured is very much about focused on product for the majority of our community hubs. So whether you're developing on SharePoint, whether you're interested in looking at developing apps for Teams, some of those areas are hidden within those community hubs. So use our powerful search tools to find the development areas that you're looking for.
Our next stop is at LinkedIn Learning.
Hi, I'm Sharon Bennett. I'm a senior IT instructor with LinkedIn Learning.
When someone goes to LinkedIn Learning, what will they find there and how do they get started?
Well, they're going to find over 15,000 courses. That's a lot of courses. So to get started, the best thing to do is search for a topic, or you can use one of our curated LinkedIn Learning paths.
Why should developers go to LinkedIn Learning?
As a developer, you'll want to come to LinkedIn Learning because we offer a variety of frameworks and libraries. We also offer Q&A, study groups, and code challenges.
How do developers get started with LinkedIn Learning?
To make you feel at home, you can follow your favorite instructor because having that familiar voice is very helpful. We also include a lot of our code and examples in GitHub. You're already there. You can pull it down and follow along at your own pace on your own system.
Are there any tips for developers?
A great tip for developers is, again, follow your favorite instructors and leverage that GitHub repo. You can branch from that and create your own code from the examples you've already learned.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.